fading out. What a world, what a world. Chapter 3, The Demon Drink. So what happened to get you, push you right over into drinking? Was it a gradual thing? Oh, it looks like a water painting. Well, at least I can dry off now. What's this? Now we've got, what is that, a book? It looks like a book. Speed up, thank you. Jump, thank you. Now I'll be collecting books.
There was one resounding consequence to the breakup with the other teacher. Shortly afterwards, my drinking started to spiral out of control.
Why? You liked her that much? You lost confidence? So I never got to go to that house or whatever that building was that went out over the lake. I wanted to check that out.
Perhaps it shouldn't have come as a surprise. My father had been something of a drinker when I was young, though he did manage to reduce his intake by the time I left home, thanks to the numerous threats of divorce from my mother. The irony wasn't lost on me. My father partially conquered his alcoholism to keep a woman in his life, while losing two women in my own only drew me closer to the demon drink.
Really? So that did affect you? I mean, he didn't really... I didn't think that he was devastated by her leaving. I mean, I know 6 months, a lot can happen in 6 months, but the way he talked about it did not seem like it was that much of a big deal. I can't hop fences, but I have jump capability. We're literally fenced in. Can jump it. Wow.
I never hit him. Not before the drink, and not after.
Good.
It just didn't affect me that way. Alcohol didn't make me violent, it made me negligent.
Not good either, but good to hear he wasn't violent. Was that a deer? Yeah. It's unusual. They don't always do that. I mean, they do walk normally as well. They go everywhere jumping like that. Okay. Am I gonna get to the other side of this fence and see that stuff, or is it just gonna...
Which isn't to say that I wasn't known for my occasional bouts of verbal aggression. That much I can't deny, and I probably raised my voice to Emily more often than I should have. I certainly recall at least one occasion when I reduced her to tears, and there were probably other occasions that I simply can't remember. But I never hurt her physically. That much I'm certain of. That just wasn't who I was, or who I am today. I might be a weak man, but I'm not a total coward.
Good to know. We're looking for books now. Grab some books. At least I think it's a book. Didn't know title on the page, on the cover, or anything like that.
At first, my work wasn't affected, at least not noticeably. As the months progressed, however, I found myself substituting the water in my plastic bottle for vodka. Only sometimes, on especially hard days, and only a partially full bottle. No one ever knew, of course, though my work performance was questioned on one or two occasions. That said, my job was never in threat, at least for the first year or so. Then came the day of a certain small incident, and, well...
A small incident? Are you sure it was a small incident? Second book. So they're always gonna be on these... barrels?
I wasn't violent towards the boy. Again, that just wasn't my style,
sober
or otherwise.
What boy?
But I definitely raised my voice at him and demanded that he leave my classroom and never darken my doorstep again. I might have even sworn at him. The official report certainly claims that I did.
The official report. Never darken my doorstep again. I didn't know anyone said anything like that anymore. Oh. Another axe, which you could not remove in the first. Yep. Once again, cannot remove. The first bottle was right by our house where we started out. We're very open right now. I don't know where the hell I'm supposed to go.
What can I say? His disruptive behavior was difficult enough to tolerate, even when I was in a fitter state to endure such nonsense. But things were starting to deteriorate in my life generally, to the point where Emily's grandparents were starting to intervene a little, and I guess I took my frustrations out on him rather than her.
Okay. This is a huge area. All of a sudden, we're all open here, and I don't... I want to find books, if there are any books to find. I know what's going to happen if I jump down there, and I'm going to be... placed somewhere else along this, and I don't want to go where it's going to place me. Probably. But then it looks like I can go down there, doesn't it? No. Yeah, it placed me back here, is what I thought. Alright, so we're gonna... So it's not as open as I thought. Because it ends here, which I didn't realize. music sounds a little more suspenseful, doesn't it? Got any books around? Got some books. So he goes on his pilgrimage every year, and someone lays out fruit, umbrellas, and books for him to collect. So kind of like a treasure hunt. I don't think it's part of the plot. It would be entertaining to me if it was. Let's just see if anything tucked away back here. Around here that I might have missed. I know I'm doubling back, guys. I just want to make sure there's no little barrel with a book on it. I'm not seeing anything, so. So glad we can walk at least a little bit faster. Certainly a lot more ground to cover. I see a barrel. So what does the book represent? What do the melons represent? I know what the umbrellas represent. It's raining. They get too drunk and book 'em Dano? Drunk and disorderly?
There's no denying that boy deserved my wrath more than my daughter. I was put on suspension since I hardly had a history of these things. I'd been a good worker up to that point, I honestly had. Go sort yourself out, they said. I had every intention of doing just that.
Every intention, but did you actually do it? What's this? Batteries? Listen to another message. So when I was in kindergarten, we had a teacher who had a problem. She would drag kids up by the hair, and I don't know, because I was five, so I might be like over dramatizing this stuff. But to my memory, she'd lift me all the way up off the ground by my hair. Just looking back, I kind of doubt that that was what happened. But they said she had had a nasty divorce or something. Was going through a divorce. Okay, we've got plenty of drink here. And she said that was to blame for it. I mean, well, she was to blame, but that was what was going on with her. But she was fired, you know. Can't drag kids around by their hair.
Darling, you can't keep blaming yourself for what happened. Not to me.
And not to Emily? Or not to that boy? Alright, watch her go towards the mist. Or that's him. From last year. Man, I can't move for a second. Interlude 3. It seemed quicker. $3, I think. Or 4. I think it was 4. The one in the house with number 4, I believe. About to fade out, aren't we? Get ready to fade out. Are we not? Are we not fading out? What's this? You're gonna fade out before I can explore that, aren't you? I hear water. Or liquid of some kind. What? What? Hey! Damn it. Let me in there. Kidding me, I can't go in there? If you get all the books, you get a different ending. Or all the items. We're going on a boat ride. Oh, birdie. Oh, it looks like, what the hell is that? Oh my god. I gotta go play with the croc. Oh, I can't. This time, no fade to white. Under the water a little bit more than that. We've got something else, a different kind of instrument.
The path to recovery is never an easy one, and I wasn't convinced that cold turkey was my answer. It just sounded too convenient to me and seemed a surefire way to fall straight back off the wagon. I suspected that slowly weaning myself off the drink would reap more permanent rewards, and immediately set about reducing my intake. A fortnight later, it was still a daily habit, but at least that habit had shifted mostly to nights. After talking Emily's grandparents around, convincing them this was the first step on my road to recovery, I soon organized a trip to one of our favorite beaches, a retreat we'd been to a couple of times before. It would be a week's trip, during her school holidays, away from the stresses of both our lives. Emily was happy, especially after I explained to her that this was Daddy's chance to get better. At the very least, that was the plan.
Yeah, the plan. I intended to... Noting the wording here of what he's saying. Specific words spoken. Oh, wow. Very camouflaged. Very, I did not see that until it moved. Is there going to glow coming over there? Here? Into the caves of despair? Interlude 3? Brave little soul. Aww. Referring to his daughter? Me in. What are we going to be collecting in this area, I wonder? Maybe mittens. I didn't miss anything, right? Back here? I mean, I don't know what we're looking for, but this seems like a good area to put it in if we were to have something to look for. Hmm.
I always tried to make holidays a thing in our little family, for the short time such a unit existed. I was more of a summery person, while my wife adored the snow. Perhaps it was her Russian roots. Our daughter was happy almost anywhere and everywhere, but there's no denying she felt the cold more than any of us.
Oh, really?
Daddy, Kiri's shivering. Needs more fire. We all knew, of course, that she was referring to herself and not the rabbit, but if that was her way of appearing courageous, we were willing to go along with it. I rugged up and left the two ladies in the log cabin in search of wood to feed the fireplace.
Huh. Okay. It's letting us know we have to find that, I guess, because otherwise we normally would not pick it up. So we're gathering wood for the fireplace. Alright. Got it. We didn't have an icon appear like that the first time, did we? I mean, the other times? I don't think so. I don't think we did. This goes on for quite a while, maybe? This is a little side thing. Did we never return or something? That'd be so sad.